നമ്മുടെ ഇപ്രാവശ്യത്തെ ഈ ഉപവാസ പ്രാർത്ഥന കഴിഞ്ഞ പ്രാവശ്യത്തെക്കാളും ബ്ലെസ്സിംഗ് ആണ്. ഞാനത് അറിയുന്നുണ്ട്, പല രീതിയിൽ അറിയുന്നുണ്ട്. അറിയുന്ന ഒരു രീതി നമ്മുടെ അകത്ത് ഒരുപാട് വ്യത്യാസം വരുന്നു, വേറൊരു രീതി പ്രതികൂലം വർദ്ധിക്കുന്നു. ഇവിടെ എല്ലാം നമുക്ക് ഉറച്ചു നിൽക്കാൻ കർത്താവ് നമ്മളെ സഹായിക്കട്ടെ എന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. കർത്താവ് സഹായിക്കും. കഴിഞ്ഞ ദിവസം നമുക്ക് കിട്ടിയ വാഗ്ദത്തം, ഈ സ്ഥലത്ത് കഴിക്കുന്ന പ്രാർത്ഥനകൾക്ക് ഉത്തരം ഉണ്ടാകും. രണ്ട് ദിനവൃത്താന്തം 15:7-15, അപ്പൊ അതൊരു പ്രോമിസ് ആയിട്ട് ദൈവമക്കൾ എടുക്കണം. സെക്കൻഡ് ക്രോണിക്കൾസ് 7:14-15, അത് കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ട് നമുക്ക് ഇവിടെ വരാം. സെക്കൻഡ് ക്രോണിക്കൽ 7:14-15 നമുക്ക് വായിച്ച് നമുക്ക് എഴുതിയെടുക്കാമെങ്കിൽ എഴുതിയെടുക്കണം. ബിക്കോസ് ഇത് നമ്മൾ ഫോളോ ചെയ്യണം. എന്റെ നാമം വിളിക്കുന്ന എന്റെ ജനം അല്ല, 7:15, ഈ സ്ഥലത്ത് കഴിക്കുന്ന പ്രാർത്ഥനയ്ക്ക് എന്റെ കണ്ണ് തുറന്നിരിക്കുകയും എന്റെ ചെവി ശ്രദ്ധിച്ചിരിക്കുകയും ചെയ്യും. അതായത് നമുക്ക് കർത്താവ് തന്ന വാഗ്ദത്തമാണ്. ഞായറാഴ്ച വൈകിട്ട് കർത്താവ് നമുക്ക് തന്ന വാഗ്ദത്തമാണ്. ഞാൻ അതിവിടെ പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ച് ദൂത് പറയുന്നതിന് മുമ്പ് ഒരാളുടെ ഹൃദയത്തിലേക്ക് ഇതേ ചിന്ത കർത്താവ് ഇട്ടു. വെൻ യു പ്രേ, ഇവിടെ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്ന പ്രാർത്ഥനയ്ക്ക് ഉത്തരം കിട്ടും. അതിനൊരുപാട് അർത്ഥങ്ങളുണ്ട്. ഒന്ന്, ഗോഡ് ഈസ് അക്നോളജിങ് ദിസ് ആസ് എ ചർച്ച്. ഇതിനൊരു സഭയുടെ അംഗീകാരം ദൈവം കൊടുക്കുക. ദൈവം അംഗീകരിക്കാത്ത ഒരു സഭയെ സഭയാക്കാനൊക്കത്തിൽ. ദിസ് ഇസ് എ ചർച്ച്. ഓക്കെ, നിങ്ങൾ ചോദിക്കാം, അപ്പൊ ഇത്രയും നാള് നമ്മൾ എന്തോ ചെയ്ത്. ഓക്കെ, വി വർ എ ചർച്ച് ബട്ട് ഗോഡ്സ് അപ്രൂവൽ ഈസ് ഓൺ അസ്. Unless God approves, nothing works. ദൈവം അംഗീകരിക്കാതെ ഒന്നും നടക്കത്തില്ല. ദൈവം അംഗീകരിക്കണം. ദൈവത്തിന്റെ അംഗീകാരം പുതിയ നിയമത്തിലുണ്ട്, പഴയ നിയമത്തിലുണ്ട്. ഈ വചനം വരുമ്പോൾ, you and I are officially approved as a church that is managed by Almighty God. അതെപ്പോഴും ഓർത്തോണം. നമ്പർ വൺ. ടു, ഈ ലൊക്കാലിറ്റി നമ്മളെല്ലാവരും കൂടിയിരിക്കുമ്പോൾ, വി കോൾ ഇറ്റ് കൊയിനോണിയ ഓർ ഫെലോഷിപ്പ്. ഇതൊരു ഗ്രീക്ക് വേർഡാണ്, കൊയിനോണിയ, വിച്ച് മീൻസ് ഫെലോഷിപ്പ് ഓർ കമ്മ്യൂണിയൻ വാട് എവർ ഫെലോഷിപ്പ്. നമ്മുടെ ഈ കൂട്ടായ്മയിൽ നടക്കുന്ന പ്രാർത്ഥനകൾക്ക് ദൈവം ഉത്തരം തരും. ഗോഡ് വിൽ ആൻസർ യുവർ പ്രേയേഴ്സ്. സോ ഹൗ ഡു വി റിയാക്ട് ടു ദിസ്? വാട്ട് ഈസ് ദ വൈസ് വേ ഓഫ് റിയാക്ടിങ് ടു ദിസ്? ഇതിനോട് നമ്മൾ എങ്ങനെ, അവിടെ ഇരിക്കുന്ന എല്ലാവർക്കും ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് അറിയാം. ഹൗ ഡു വി റിയാക്ട് ടു ദിസ്? ഇന്റലിജന്റ് പ്രയർ. മേക്ക് ഇന്റലിജന്റ് പ്രയേഴ്സ്, മേക്ക് മീനിങ് ഫുൾ പ്രയേഴ്സ്. ഓക്കെ, വി വിൽ ലുക്ക് എ ബിറ്റ് ഇൻ ടു പ്രയേഴ്സ് ടുഡേ, ഹൗ ടു പ്രേ ഇന്റലിജന്റ്ലി. ദിസ് മോർണിംഗ് ഐ ഹേർഡ് എ ലേഡി, ഷീ വാസ് ടെലിംഗ് മീ, Pastor, what is the point? I go to that Pentecostal church and they are just jumping up and down, the doesn't make sense. They are saying some words which we don't understand. What is all this? See, we have a responsibility even when we speak in tongues, even when, okay, here it is okay because we are all in the family. But I'm telling you, in churches, God expects us to do things wisely. When you are in a church, this is not a church meeting, this is a family meeting. Okay? You alone, we can all pray. I'm not touching anybody's prayer. You all prayed well. Praise God. And those who didn't pray, I advise you to pray. Start praying in public. It will be a big exercise in faith. It will lift your faith and your ability. But Paul said something intelligent. If a person who does not know God comes into the church, and if you're not able to translate the tongues that you speak, then what is the point? How will he understand? So whenever you pray in tongues, remember, ask the Lord, Lord, please give me a translation for that. For example, when you prayed today, suddenly the Spirit of the Lord came upon you, you started to cry. You spoke in tongues. What were you praying? You were actually praying for lost souls. All the things that came after was the translation of your prayer in tongues. Because I can understand that. Always remember, we are not people who will overcome. I mean, we don't say, no, we don't speak in tongues. We do speak in tongues. In our church, we have the full acceptance of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit controls everything here. Everything is under His control. At the same time, the Holy Spirit also, remember, loves the whole world. Or let's say God loves the whole world, doesn't He? And when we use these gifts, it is God's desire that people will come to know Him. So, go to 2 Corinthians chapter. Let me read that for you from there. Or 2 Corinthians 7. First Corinthians 14. Let me see. Yeah. 14:16, saints. 1 Corinthians 14:16. 1 Corinthians 14:16. Can you go to a couple of verses before this? Wherefore, let him that speak in an unknown tongue pray. That means you have an ability to speak in unknown tongues. Start praying. Lord, give me the ability to interpret. Interpret into the language which other people? No. What is the purpose? Verse 14. For if I pray in an unknown tongue, my spirit prays, but my understanding is unfruitful. So intelligent prayer is fruitful prayer, or my intelligence will be fruitful. So we are talking today about intelligent prayer. I hope my spelling is right. If it is not, bear with me. I don't know if intelligence has 2L or 1L. 2L, okay. Intelligent prayer. Number one is fruitful. 2L? Yeah. It is fruitful. Only one L? Wow. Fruitful. Intelligent prayer is number one, fruitful. Okay. Two, it bears witness with the Holy Spirit. Three, it definitely fetches answers. It definitely brings, let me use a simple word, brings answers. And I wanted to encourage you by telling 90% of the answers is what you want. Many people say, you know, God will listen to your prayer, but you may not receive what you expect. Not all the time. God wants to answer your prayer. Rarely, He may not give you what you ask for. Why? So He can give you something better. നിങ്ങൾക്ക് എനിക്ക് അല്പം കൂടെ ശ്രേഷ്ഠമായത് തരുവാൻ വേണ്ടി നമ്മൾ ചോദിച്ചത് തന്നില്ലെന്നിരിക്കും. So do not mistake the heart of God by saying, you know, I've been praying. Who knows what God will give? Whatever I get, I will receive. These are all pagan ideas of God. I also grew up with these. Even after being born in a Christian family, I also grew up with these all kinds of thoughts. You know, we can ask God, who knows what we will get wrong. You ask God and He will give you what you ask for. Because you are children, because Leah is my daughter, I may not allow give her my car. Why? If she says, Dad, I'll drive the car, I said, no. Wait another year till you are able to drive. Driving padikyan viti. Okay, now you can take it. Did you get that? God's delays are not His denials. This is true. See, if you keep this attitude, it's so easy to pray. Your expectation goes up. Imagine going with the old understanding, you know, I will pray. I will go for fasting and prayer. Who knows if God will listen to my prayer? Two, if at all God listens to my prayer, He may give what I ask for. 90% the chances are He may not get. He will give you what you ask for. Please, my dear brothers and sisters, please understand this. Fasting prayer is the time when we renew our minds. It is not for you to go hungry, and we have nothing to prove to anybody that we are going hungry for nothing. That's not fasting. If you fast, it's not going hungry. Remember, if you skip a meal, I advise that, or two meals, ask the Lord to fill you with more. Especially, He will give you grace. Do not think that fasting is a hunger strike. But rather, it's a discipline. I do a lot of fasting. Even now I am. It's a good discipline where you are in control. You say, Lord, I want to skip this meal today. But I am, you know, my health is in your hands. I know you will bless me. I know you will give me something in its place. Always remember that. We are fasting for many reasons. One of the reasons is when we are bringing a control on our physical senses. We, there are some things the body keeps on demanding. Okay, I will bring that to control so I can spend more time in prayer. All these things are good. You got that? But do not fast for the wrong reasons. Never think that God looks at your hunger strike and begins to do things. You don't need that. We are His children, makala. Okay. So let me start one after the other. Intelligent prayer is number one, fruitful. There are many, many things about being fruitful. Number one, here it says, my understanding is unfruitful, which means if you pray in your language, your understanding will become fruitful. Buthil pratichal, buthikyaka tendu gittum, koodil buthi gittum anna ayinde artham. Even as you pray intelligently, your intelligence also becomes, you know, the biggest problem, the biggest attack against Pentecostals? Yadaru vivaram illa. The people say that. Oru level illatha. Chumma kadannu bahalam undakichu po. I don't want that about our church. Nammal chumma kadannu bahalam undakunnavaralla. When you pray, Heavenly Father, I love you. I know that you love me. See, when you pray like that, the sonship inside you is actually increasing. Oh yeah, I'm a son. Wow, what a privilege. And Heavenly Father, God, who created all these things, He's my daddy. Your intelligence, your understanding, your awareness is increasing. Oh God, thank you. You know, the whole being is acknowledging to the fact. And you can simply say that in your own language. Wow, thank you, Jesus. And then simply put your request. Lord, your word says, before I have a need, you already know it. അറിയുന്നതിനും എൻ്റെ ഞാൻ നിന്നോട് പറയുന്നതിന് മുമ്പേ എൻ്റെ ആവശ്യം എന്താ നീ അറിയുന്നുണ്ട്. But I am still, എന്നാലും ഞാൻ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കാം. See, what an assurance. അതൊക്കെ പറയുമ്പോൾ എന്തൊരു ഉറപ്പാ. ഞാൻ മരിക്കുന്ന ഈ ലോകം വിട്ടു പോകുന്നത് വരെയും. I felt you, sister, you wanted me to speak in Malayalam. That's why I'm speaking in Malayalam. Huh? Okay. So, അതുകൊണ്ടാണ് ഞാനിങ്ങനെ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നത്. എന്താ എന്റെ എനിക്ക് ഒത്തിരി ആവശ്യങ്ങളുണ്ട്. ടിൽ ദ ലാസ്റ്റ് ഡേ ഓഫ് മൈ ലൈഫ് യു നോ എവറിഥിങ്. എല്ലാം അറിയാം. ദാറ്റ് അഷ്വറൻസ് ഇസ് ദയർ. ഐ ഡോണ്ട് ഹാവ് ടു വറി ആൻഡ് തിങ്ക് വിൽ മൈ ഫൈനാൻസ് കം, വിൽ മൈ മണി കം, യു നോ വാട്ട് ഈസ് ഗോൺ ടു ഹാപ്പൻ ടു മൈ ഫ്യൂച്ചർ, എന്റെ തലമുറയ്ക്ക് എന്തായി തീരും, ഇതൊന്നും ഇവിടെ വേണ്ട. ബിക്കോസ് ഐ ഹാവ് എ സിമ്പിൾ വേർഡ്. വാട്ട് ഈസ് ദാറ്റ് വേർഡ്? ഈവൻ ബിഫോർ യു ആസ്ക്, യുവർ ഹെവൻലി ഫാദർ നോസ്. നിങ്ങൾ ചോദിക്കുന്നതിന് മുമ്പേ നിങ്ങളുടെ സ്വർഗത്തിലെ പിതാവിന്. ബട്ട് വെൻ യു സ്പീക്ക് ദാറ്റ് ഔട്ട് ആൻഡ് പ്രേ, യുവർ മൈൻഡ് ആൻഡ് യുവർ മെമ്മറി ഇസ് വെരി ആക്ടിവേറ്റഡ്. ഐ ഹാവ് ഗുഡ് ന്യൂസ് ഫോർ യു. ദ ലൈഫ് സ്പാൻ ഓഫ് പീപ്പിൾ ഹു പ്രേ ലൈക്ക് ദിസ് ഇൻ ദ ഹോളി സ്പിരിറ്റ് ഇസ് വെരി ഹൈ കമ്പയർഡ് ടു പീപ്പിൾ ഹു ഡു നോട്ട് പ്രേ. പീപ്പിൾ ഹു സ്പീക്ക് ഇൻ ടങ്സ്, ദിയർ ഇന്റലിജൻസ് ഇസ് വെരി ഹൈ കമ്പയർഡ് ടു പീപ്പിൾ ഹു ഡു നോട്ട്. ഇറ്റ്സ് എ ഗിഫ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ഗാഡ്. ഓക്കെ, സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ഇന്റലിജന്റ് പ്രേയർ, ബുദ്ധിയുള്ള ഫലമുള്ള പ്രാർത്ഥന. ടു, ദിസ് ഇസ് വെരി ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻറ്റ്. An intelligent prayer bears witness with the Holy Spirit. That means if you pray something against God's word, the Holy Spirit will tell you, hey, that's not a prayer. Wrong prayer, wrong prayer. I heard something today that somebody was praying to dislocate somebody's job because they had an argument. You know, just imagine. I said, that is not the prayer. God doesn't agree with such kind of prayer. That's ridiculous. Do you think God will stand with you to get even with someone? What kind of a God is that? That's not the God we serve. You know, I'm angry with Brother Cherian. Lord, take his job away. What kind of a prayer is that? That is ridiculous. Our prayer always bears witness with the Holy Ghost. Oh Lord, bless my brother. Even if something went wrong, make sure that the devil doesn't touch him. We may have differences, but guard him and protect him all the time. And I have a testimony to tell you. There are a lot of people, you know, in their ignorance, you know, in the past, many people have hurt me. Okay. But I have always covered them in prayer. I said, Lord, even if they are not in the church. And the other day, I saw one of them, accidentally. Very accidentally, long time, no see. Okay. You know, I didn't even know. I said, wow, long time, where are you? How are you? I mean, I didn't see any offense or hurt there. And the person also said, was shocked. Asked, do you have still the same number? I said, yeah, call me sometime. Where are you and all that, you know. In fact, I gave my card also. Never called back. But you see, my conscience is clear. That's the way God works. Because one of the reasons is, I pray for people. No matter what people do to you, God has taught me a righteousness balance. You know what it is? Let us imagine somebody has a problem with us. This is a balance. According to my understanding, okay, this person is at fault. It may be true. But what I should realize is God loves that person also. In spite of all the weakness of that person. Okay, God may be keeping me away for a reason, for my safety. But I'm not supposed to pray for the destruction of this person. It is the devil who comes to kill, steal, and destroy. So saints, whenever we pray, make sure that the Holy Spirit witnesses. Yeah, yeah, that's a good prayer, son. Go ahead and pray. I am with you. I'll make sure that you get the... Okay? Three. Our prayer definitely will bring answers. You will receive. Number one, I told you, you can say 99% of our prayers will get direct results. Well, it's very cold for you, isn't it? Yeah. Can you bring down the AC? Let's switch off the AC and see for some time. From yesterday, we have been sensing some kind of a cold wave or cool wave, so to speak. Huh? You want to? Lenny needs that. Maybe you can sit on this side. No. You both can sit this side. Come. Try to adjust. Okay. See, 99% of our prayers will get direct answers. How do I know this? Let's look in the scriptures and see if this is true. Kindly turn with me to the book of Matthew. Chapter 6. Chapter 6 onwards, it's all about pray. It says, you ask for it's in Luke 11 also. I'll tell you this in a minute. Matthew 7:10, you're right. Matthew 7:10. Understand the character of God. Matthew 7:10. Did you get it? Read that for me. See, what were we thinking all these days? We will ask him. If he gives, let him give. And then also, if he gives it instead of a fish, he will give something else. That's a pagan understanding. That is why I tell you, when you ask God, be careful what you ask for. You will receive it. You will receive it. Do you understand that? 7:10. Go to verse 8. Ask and what shall be given to you? Whatever you ask. See, God is changing our mind. See, we all come from righteous backgrounds, born to God-fearing parents. And we all have heard this thing. You know, ask God, who knows if he will give? If at all he gives, he may give what he likes to give. Wrong. Ask. You'll get it. Seek. Knock. And this is by the way, question. This is a privilege for the people of God, us, not for everybody. This is for us. Because we are asking the Father. This is a relationship between the Father and the children. Tina can ask her parents. You know, somebody else goes and asks them, they said, excuse me, we don't even know you. Same relationship. Our children can come and ask us. Of course, we say, children, all that we have is for you. We are struggling for you. Isn't that true? See? So remember, ask and it shall be given to you. The Lord is confirming his word to this church. Whatever you pray here will be given to you. It's confirmed. It's attitude. Attitude has to change. Attitudes have to change. It is changing today. So 99% of our prayers get direct answers. We have proved it through the word of God. And come down, brother. Still, we need to confirm this. Still, let's come down. For everyone that asks receives. And whoever seeks finds. And to him that knocks, it shall be opened. Jesus is going away and say, everyone. Everyone. That means, you should remember, this is in the background, it's in the context of the Jewish people that he was talking. They were in a covenant with God. You and I are in a greater covenant than Jewish people. We are in the covenant of being a son. They were in the covenant of being a servant. We are sons. Okay, verse 9. That's just for our understanding. Now listen to this. What man is there of you who, if his son asks bread, will give him a stone? See, ask a... Okay, next one. Keep it there. Okay, keep it there. Ask bread, you will get bread. Something interesting, very interesting is coming up. Verse 10. Ask fish, you will get fish. 11. If you then being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more shall your heavenly Father, which is in heaven, give good things to them that ask him? You will get what you ask. Let that go deep into our mind. You know what, saints, I have observed, I have learned. There are many pictures on the walls of your mind like this. Some of it need to be broken. There are many pictures pinned on the walls of your mind which you see every day. Probably you're not aware of it. How many of you really looked into the picture on your wall today, morning specifically? Very few people did. Nobody does. Most of the time people look into the picture of their mental wall when the picture is pasted there, correct? Like that, there are many ideologies that are in our mind. Today, the Lord is breaking one of that. He's taking it out of your mind and putting it in the trash bag. What is it? You may or may not receive an answer. If at all you receive an answer, it is what the Lord wants to give you. Remove that frame from the wall. Write this verse there. Whatever I ask, he will give. Okay, now let's move to Luke 11:13, because the same, I want you to understand something there. The same thing is mentioned there in Luke 11:13, but with a small difference. Hallelujah. Luke 11, 11, brother, 11. Luke 11. See, the same thing, but Luke is expressing it in a different way. If you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more shall your heavenly Father give good things, is what Matthew said. But what is Luke saying? Why? Is there a difference in theology? No. The Holy Spirit is good things. The Holy Spirit is all things. This is a spiritual truth, which we will explain in a minute. If I ask God, He will give me all that I ask. And with what I ask, He will give me the Holy Spirit also. What a beautiful way. You know, I'm going to look into an area of life which people normally fail, or people don't graduate, or people don't come out of those system. Okay? Let's take the area of finances. Why do we work? This is just to make us understand. This is a practical thing. It is good for us. We will learn a lot of things. At the same time, we will be able to equate with this. Okay. Why do we work? A. I'm going to put pay mortgage. B. Bills. C. Food. 99% of immigrants work for this. And they say, if there is an extra, we will save it for a rainy day. Correct? Very good. For generations, this has been the scenario. Most people pay mortgage, pay bills, have food, save it. Why do we save it? For the next generation. Very good. This is good. In other words, this is a mindset that has been in us for generations. And thank God none of us lacked. Did we lack? Our parents, at the right time, they gave us education. They saved for our education. Or maybe they didn't save, they always provided. We got good education. We got good jobs. And we are completing that. You are following up with that. Generation after generation. Same thing. Okay, now. There is never a story of abundance. 99%, or let us even say 95% of people in the world, they never have an abundance. Shortage, it's okay. No shortage. You ask people, how are things going on? You know, God is good. We have enough. Yeah. You know, for how many generations this is going on? Now, let me talk about people in India, people in Kerala. God opened a way for them to be prosperous when the Gulf door opened. You know what they did? The majority of them went to Gulf. They had 1 acre back at home, let us say, or 50 cents. They came back. They remodeled their father's house. When the father and mother was living in olden days, they had one bedroom, which was also a living room. And, that was needed in those days. When they came from the Gulf country, they added one more bedroom. And they whitewashed or gave some paint. And they gave the idea because somebody is getting married. In other words, they don't want a different big house. Because somebody taught them, if you have a big house, you'll go to hell. mindset. Then God opened a way to bring people to the United States of America. There also they are living with this mindset of, you know why? Their things are taken care of. They are not mindful of a bigger kingdom. What did God say? Be concerned about my kingdom. Did you get that? This is not a teaching for you to give. Don't get me wrong. I am making it to understand the principles of God. Okay? Where are you? Okay? Okay. So listen. This kind of a mindset, even if God gave you the entire kingdom, you are going to tell him, as long as me, my family, my pastor, my church, we are taken care of, we are happy, Lord. Wrong mindset. Why? Because God wants you to give. And you say, you know, we are trying to give. Our pastor okay, our people okay, church is okay, family is okay, we are okay. How can you give if you don't have? Did you get this? How do you think, you know, there are many sides of looking into how ask you to give. How can you give without having? See, if he comes and if I want to give him a shirt, I should have two, isn't it? Or I should have the money to give him a shirt. I should have a heart to give him a shirt. And I cannot give if I'm poor. Did you understand the principle? So God wants you to have so that you can give. But how can you, the difference between giving from a poor heart and the difference and from a heart that has, you know, this is a heart that has. This is a heart that is living in poverty. All people in this world are poor in their heart. They don't have anybody, even the richest man, even the multi-billionaire in America. He may have bank balances, but he doesn't have, because you have to have a heart to give. That heart to give comes from the Holy Spirit. You know, many people tell me, why don't you press, nobody in our church. But pastors and all say, why don't you squeeze the people to give? I said, no way. Where are they going to give from? From what? So I want you to know this. If you have the Holy Spirit, then he will begin to pour out. This is having means having the Holy Spirit. I have the Holy Spirit. His nature is to give. I begin to give. There is a result. Your giving will be joyful. And I tell you from life, you will never lack. Stage number one, you will always have abundance. Because God is nobody's debtor. So you're not giving from your poverty. You're giving from your fullness. This is the missing link teaching which I want the church to have. We all give from a joyful heart. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, 6, what does it say? God loves a cheerful giver. And who is a cheerful giver? One who has to give. And where is his abundance coming from? Not from the bank balance, but from the Holy Spirit. Is the picture clear? You know, that is why for so many years, you know, people have been telling me, Pastor, is this guy really a Pentecostal pastor? Because we don't see him carrying the thing around. But what people do not understand is many people in America do the same thing which I am doing. They keep the box there. And they say, saints, may the Lord lead you. Not from what you think you have. You know, it's a gift to give. If you have the Holy Spirit, it will come. Just to let you know, I mean, I'm not boasting, but God takes good care of us. Our daughters, by the way, have found good admissions in all the four colleges, nursing colleges. Okay, four of them. Shortly, I'll release their pictures with all the addresses and all that, so you can pray as a church. Okay, some of you were kind. Today, if you ask me, one of the men of God, we have helped another man of God in Mumbai to build his church, a building up. Even when we are looking for a building, you know, God has given us grace to do that. It is coming up. Even yesterday we had a talk. Why? Because we know the Lord is with us. Yeah. The Lord is with us. And if we give, we will never lack. We will always have enough for our needs. And we definitely are going to come to abundance. That's Christian giving. That is what you mean by Luke 11:13 and Matthew 7. All things you have, give from that all things. If you ask, will not your heavenly Father give you good things? Chodicha nalla daanangale tarum. Chodichal parishuddhaatmaavine parishuddhaatmaavu undayittu ningalku kodukkaadirikkan pattathillenna ende chinda. You will give your life, you will give your time as you pray today correctly. You know, whoever is born again must not consider himself, but he should always be giving himself to your time, not only finances, time. You know, you should sometime think, Lord, you should pray like this, Lord, let somebody call me who I can counsel over the phone. Giving is not just money. Did you understand that? You know how many hours I give every week? You calculate. 40 days into 2 hours, 4 hours, at least 150 hours. You know who I am giving it to? Your Heavenly Father. Because He gave me in the Holy Spirit to give to you, I am also receiving. Because you receive, I am able to bring in more revelation. Okay. So remember, bottom line, saints, today is this. Ask, it shall be given to you. Not only what you ask, but the Holy Spirit, which God wants to pour out mightily on you. And when you have the Holy Spirit in you, giving doesn't become a problem. Rather, I'm going to tell you something, I hope you understand it very well. In the right sense, without greed or covetousness, all these things apart. But giving, you can control your finance. Did you understand that? You can control your entire finance with your $10 giving. Is it difficult for you to understand? You control your entire finance. You control your entire, let me say, portfolio. Supposing you are people with, you have stock exchange. You are investing in the stock. You control it with a small giving. Lord, this is what I have, but I am giving it to you joyfully because I feel happy in my spirit. I am happy. I want the Holy Spirit. You may be giving $10, but that $10 which you give happily, that $10 can control your entire estate because that $10 has been given into the Lord's hand. And where did you get that $10 from? From the Lord. You see how I have had so many experiences. You know, whatever salary I have, I have always been taught to live with content. Okay, thank you, Lord. Praise. I'm happy. You know how God arranges supplies, how God arranges circumstances. I have a wonderful testimony which many of you saw. My car tire had, my car, new car, it's 3 years old now, run 50,000 miles already. In the last, the tires were all broken and it was not immediately available. Somebody took my car and gave me all the new 4 tires and tubes. I didn't have money. Way in which you begin to God. Somebody in the church, you know, I said this once. I think probably for some reason, he comes and washes my car. Yeah, and I have never seen a job like that. Thorough job. It's a giving. He's giving to the Lord his time, his energy. He's giving to the Lord. He's serving the man of God and his car. Is that giving? Yes. God accepts it. It may not be. See, some people may have money to give. Okay? Some people may not have money, but there you can find different ways of giving. I'm teaching you a secret, which I don't know how many pastors will teach you, but If there are pastors who agree with me, God bless them. But I know what I am speaking is right. See, some people, different people have different things in abundance. Can you think of one thing that you have in abundance? Tell me. There are many things in this world that you can have in abundance. Time is as luxurious as money. Money is another thing. Everybody thinks having a lot of money is being rich. Wrong. You can have a lot of money and you can still be dumb. Wisdom is a big rich. Time, money, wisdom. How about experience? Lot of young people, they want this. Lee, I've been through this. I know I burned my finger. I don't want that to happen to you. Giving a good advice to a younger person in need is your giving to God. Church. Okay. Now, let us say there are 3 or 4 believers. A, B, C, D. Let us say A has plenty of time. B has plenty of money. Let's say C has plenty of wisdom. And D has plenty of experience. Now when God tells them to give, where is he telling them to give from? From their abundance. Okay? So A has plenty of time. Lord, how can I give you my time? Did you get that? When you begin to invest it to God happily, the Bible says you can have abundance in all these things. Isn't that a great plan of God? I've heard American preachers preaching, give money, you get money. That is not the kingdom of God. That is not, you know, seeding. I teach seeding here, but with the spirit of God. $10, get $100 back. This is not a jackpot. Kingdom of God is not a jackpot. You would have seen how gambling goes. But I tell you, if you have excess of money, when you seed, if you have excess of wisdom, you know, if you have experience, for example, you may say, Pastor, where do we find an outlet? You would have seen the Voice of Revival. You should write down. You know, for example, I'm just giving an example. If any of you know recipes, good recipes to make food, and you like to share it with the church, write it there. It will bless somebody. Give it to the Lord. I know this sounds foolish. Many people who hear this teaching will laugh. Yeah, see, there you go. So much, we have so much. Give that to the Lord. And then you will see an abundance in all these things. Do not limit your giving to money. If you have money, definitely, okay. Set 10%, give. And then over and above that, whatever you give is giving. Okay, 10% belongs to God. Time, your 10% belongs to God. You know, we take time to sleep, eat. How many hours do we give to God? Now for the fasting and prayer, we are spending 2 hours, 2 into 4. Well, that also is for us, by the way. Do you know we can give to God without bringing all our problems all the time to God? For many people, prayer is always bringing their problems. Lord, I'm going to die tomorrow. Give me some food today. That's the way we people, please don't pray this. I mean, not here. Nobody prayed like that. I'm telling you generally. Lord, I want to minister to you. Read Acts 13 quickly. Acts 13 and see how we can minister to God without bringing all our petitions and supplications every time. Acts 13, 1. Verse 2. They ministered to the Lord and fasted. That's a beautiful place to be. You know, when you pray, saints, Lord, give me this, give me that, give me. Okay, he will give. But before that, Lord, I worship you. I come, apart from all my list of prayer, I worship you. No matter what my situation is, you are the same. You never change. I give you all the glory. You have been there from my grandfather's time, from my great-grandfather's time. Lord, you are precious to me. Yes, Lord, I agree with you. You are precious to me, Lord. Wow. Ministering to the Lord. Did you get that? 5 minutes, saints. 5 minutes every day. As soon as you wake up, oh Lord, oh my leg is paining, my eyes are paining, my ear is paining, still I love you. Try that. Be beautiful. Yeah, you know, our flesh, it's nobody's fault. Don't feel condemned. We have been trained and programmed in such a way to always look at our problems. But Christ, our Lord, is changing our attitude. Look at me. I have a quick question. When we die, who do you think will take care of us, our souls? Can our eyes, hands and legs move to preserve our soul? The Bible says, I will keep your soul. He protects our soul. Hand over to him completely. Even now, get used to his doing everything for you. You are focusing on him. So you see, today we have revealed something beautiful. Whatever excess you have, give it to the Lord. Give it from the fullness of your heart. Oh Lord, thank you. And then what happens when you give it in the Holy Spirit? You receive the Holy Spirit also. That's what you mean by good things. So today we end up this in prayer. Let me quickly recap and give you just the basics of what we heard. One, your prayers will be answered. You will get what you ask for. If you don't, it is because he wants to give you something better. Three, ask in the Holy Spirit. Ask for the Holy Spirit. This is two. Three, give what you have. I told you four things. When you do that, you read 2 Corinthians 9:18. God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that you having all sufficiency in all things will abound to every good work. Amen. Okay, we're going to pray now for now 5-10 minutes. We're going to pray and minister to you. Just a quick question. Any questions you have, please feel free to ask, because when we are in the church, it may be difficult, but now is the time. Yesterday, some people asked questions and we were able to answer. Yesterday's evening session, how many of you were blessed by that? How many of you were there for the evening session? How many of you were blessed by that? Deliverance has happened. I'm glad Julie asked those questions. So feel free to ask anything. According to the grace I have, I will explain. If I can't, the Lord will definitely satisfy you. I'll be able to do that. Come on, ask. Yes, you asked a question. Bottom line is, you are free at home. And now I'm going to tell you something more, which you didn't tell me. When you go home, you are free when you are alone. That is because you are afraid. You, when you come to people, you have something which they call a stage fright. Of course, you don't stand in the stage. But you're not able to relate with people, which is a problem for many people, you know. And then you go back home, your family is there. You are afraid that they will ridicule you. You don't have that confidence. But when you're alone, you are your best. There's nothing wrong in that. But you yourself know, in the last 4 or 5 years after I've seen you, tremendous amount of changes there. I remember you telling me once, don't call me to pray in front. I cannot pray. That's not the person I talk to now. Okay. Why does that happen? Good question. It happens because you are giving consent to your mind to operate completely when you are alone. Because there, you know, nobody will ridicule you. Now, I'm telling you, this is specifically for you. You have grown up in you know, even after marriage, you have gone through a lot of ridicule. Therefore, your mind is so programmed to receiving ridicule. A lot of people go through that. In your case, ridicule. Some other people, it could be anything. So you're afraid to speak out. Let me explain. If there were people sitting here who opposed me for everything I said, I'll have a tough time speaking so boldly. Oh, what is so and so going to think? What is? Yeah. But that is where you need to ask. I don't like to use the word double portion, but this is just for you. Ask for you to understand. Ask a double portion of the Holy Spirit or the anointing. What is the anointing on you? What is the anointing on each one of us? Okay, what is the anointing from the Holy Spirit? There is a difference between being baptized in the Holy Spirit and having an anointing. I've explained this, I'll explain again. We all have the Holy Spirit. But how much do we allow the Holy Spirit to work? How much do we hand over totally to Him? You know? Depending on that, you have different anointing. Anointing to teach, anointing to preach, anointing to heal, anointing. Different anointing, different ability from the same Holy Spirit. Okay? In the same way, we have an anointing in 2 Timothy. It says, you have been given not a spirit of fear, but a spirit of, number one, a sound mind. Have you heard that? You remember that? Boldness. And one more thing, love. The spirit in us is a spirit of love. The spirit in us is a spirit of boldness. The spirit in us is a spirit of a sound mind. These things need to manifest or come out. Okay? So next time you should make a prayer. Lord, I want to speak in my house loudly. You know? It is not that God is stopping you. It is that we all seem to have some kind of an intimidating factor somewhere. It can come because of our past experience. Or we may be too self-conscious. You know, some people are like that. I mean, most people are self-conscious. Oh, no. Am I wearing the right kind? Am I acceptable? You know, we all try to buy acceptance. Everybody does. You know, when you go to, as Sister Alice, you go to go teach people for the first time, even if they are toddlers, you still will they accept us? Will they access? Ask her. But over a period of time, we will get used to them, they will get used to us, and we become friends. We lose all those unnecessary inhibitions. See, I'm speaking so happily and boldly because now I know I'm speaking to my family. We are all family. You accepted me, I accepted you. But if I were to go and preach to some place who I don't know anybody, everybody's looking at me like that. Lord, give me extra grace. Yeah. Every preacher, you ask any preacher, not only Christian speakers, anybody, ask them if you are to go and face a new audience, what will you pray? Lord, that I may not fall down in the pulpit. So it's not a peculiar thing that you have. We all have that. But this is the answer for that. A double portion of the anointing. Bless me. So that even in the church I'll be able. That's why this morning I said, if you're not used to praying in church, it is not because you are less spiritual than other people. It is because other people are used to praying openly in church. You should start somewhere. You know, put one step forward. Just pray for our Makanji meeting. There's a brother who never prayed. I said, brother, just open your mouth and say, praise you, Jesus. I said, start. That's enough. It's acceptable for me. So praise you, Jesus. Then, good. That's good for a start. Because we want to see you developing as powerful. Without praying in public, without, opening up somewhere. How can you, develop? So don't worry about it. You're on the right track. Okay. So does that answer your question? You asked about praying in public, right? Does that answer your question? I don't get the fluency. This is the only reason. Only reason is this. Remember, this is why I teach righteousness in this church. If God has called you, you are precious to me. No matter what people call you. No matter what the devil may call you. God calls you, you are precious to me. And when you stand in public, remember that I am precious to God. Hallelujah. And of course, unlike other people in the world, people from India, especially women from India, you have always been trained and taught to think that you are a second-class citizen, which is wrong. Huh? Oh, definitely. Yeah, they are. They're gone up. Hey, pendang gonna marry kari bhaja. You know? Even yesterday I said this. And many women rebel because they are consistently under this oppression. It's too much, not that women want to rebel. But it is the gospel of Jesus Christ that has liberated
and said, you are also sons. You have the spirit of sonship. You are not less than men for anything. They are muscular. They are a little more muscular. They are being put in the leadership. But as I always tell in the church, leadership is not man standing sitting in the cockpit and the woman in the air hostess room. No, they are both in the cockpit and the man drives. Because God has asked him to do that. But what if the man is not able to drive? She is able to take over. She can. I want that, at least in this church, you know, if I want the suppression to go, I want people to be set free, totally serving the Lord. You know, husbands, I want to tell all of us, our success is making sure that our women really flourish. That is the success point. God will help us. He will take us there. So, you are a son. You have the spirit of sonship in you. Okay? Right? Any questions? Yes. So what is it that you expect? No. I know those symptoms. I know the reason for those symptoms also. But what do you expect to happen to you? Deliverance from that means you don't want that to occur again. It should never come back again. Okay. If you take what I tell you, it'll automatically go. Okay. You have to have now a clear purpose in life. What are you going to do in the next 10 years of your life? 10 years. Write it down. What are you going to do? What do you want to achieve in the next 10 years of your life? How are you going to get there? What is your vision? The reason I want you to know, a purposeless mind, if you don't have a goal, if you don't have a target in life, it's very easy to be caught by all these physical ailments. Because as far as I've seen about you, servants of God have come. We have prayed. You have been delivered so many times. Almost any man of God who comes have prayed for you. Still some of these things linger. Remember, one of the biggest problems was your recent developments. God has given you victory there also. Still, this is happening because I want you to know, everybody, a purpose must be there. Today, I redefine my purpose. When I started my born-again life with God, one of the things God said is, have a purpose, son, in your life. What do you want to become? What do you want to become? Today, I redefine that purpose. If you don't have a purpose in life, it's very easy to get submerged. I have nothing to do. No vision. Everybody must have your own vision. Let me tell you this. If you are hungry, what would you do? Won't you do that? If you're not hungry, and if you don't eat, okay, I don't know if any of you have children. Sometimes my children say, Papa, I don't feel hungry. You have to eat, whether you feel hungry or not. That's what a father and mother says. But if you have no hunger, children won't eat. If they don't eat, what happens? You know what will happen without food. That's the same thing. Our mind needs food. That will keep it healthy. Don't say, I'm reading the Bible and praying. My dear brothers and sisters, reading the Bible and praying is not the only food. Purpose. What is going to happen? Getting involved in things that you like to do. What do you like to do? You know your own personality. You are a people person. You can talk to people. You can talk to a lot of people. You can have friends. You are a person who can quickly make friends. You are an outgoing person. Start taking your phone. Call friends. Good friends who can equip you, strengthen you, who value you. All these things will take your eyes of yourself. And you will, without knowing, all these things will go away. Because the anointing has to go that way. I have known you for the last 4 years. I have observed you. I studied you. I know your psychology very clearly. The only person who knows better than that is the Lord himself. And I'm constant communion with the Lord for you. That's the thing. Okay? Please understand this. You know, many people say healing. Pastor, pray. I should fall down. and I should fall down. I have done that ministry. It will happen again. But do not think healing is just falling down or feeling a nice feeling and all that. Healing is from the Lord. By His stripes we are healed. Sometimes use medicine. Go ahead. Because somebody is not using medicine, God did not tell you to stop taking medicine. Don't make medicine an obsession. If a headache comes, oh Lord. No. I hope you understand that. But a different millions of ways God can heal you. And I want the whole church to know you are under healing. Let me give you some quick testimony. You all know, the parents have agreed. You know Chris? How many of you remember Chris? You know the day he came? You see him now? His mother told me he's no more in the special category of student. I don't, what do you call that, sister? Yeah, he's no more there. They have put him in the regular class. Is that healing? To me, it, okay, so when I prayed or some man of God get Chris didn't fall down, he didn't feel goose thing all over him. But the boy is healed. Our general problem is that, you know, healing, I want to see it now. No, there are different ways God wants to develop your personality, that you may be people who always serve the Lord with purpose. Okay, any other questions? Hallelujah. Can we wind up? Yes. Oh, you mean the... Oh, yeah. What is it that you follow? There is a game that you are playing on the app. It's very good. It's free. It's been a long time since I played, but it's very, very good. Yes. Yeah. Keep our mind very active, right? Elevate, peak, lumosity. This is the reason you have the... I'll talk to you in private. Okay, it's not just, or don't equate everything spiritually. Don't think, so some people for every problem, in Jesus' name, go devil. Everything is not the devil. No. Okay, sometimes you can have demonic attacks and God protects us. Sometimes it is physical, sometimes our mind needs a change. Everybody's mind needs to go out and look at different things once in a while. God never expected us to go through the same thing day after day after day after day. He gave us four seasons. One good thing about, you know, four seasons for fall, summer, winter, change. He knows. But one thing I want to tell everybody, if you want it, that is the million-dollar question. A pastor can bring the horse near the water. A pastor can bring the sheep near the water. But the pastor cannot drink it. Yeah. I cannot drink it for you. Something you have to accept. You have to agree with something. Okay. Here is a problem. Pastor says, solution number one, try this. Solution number two, try this. Three, four. You don't want to take any of this, but you still continuously talk about the problem. What is that? Because you don't want the solution. I want the church to know there is no solution, there is no problem which the Holy Spirit cannot solve. Nothing. It's a challenge. My goodness, I know how I stand. Praise God. Let's pray. Would somebody like to pray a short prayer to encourage your faith? This is a good time. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Father, we just commit every word that we heard this morning. I wholeheartedly thank you because you will give us answers and you will give us what we ask for. And today, Lord, I thank you because you have removed that mindset from many of us who never thought that you would give us what we asked for. They were always trying to please you in the wrong way. But Lord, you will give us what we ask for. And if there is a delay, it is because there is something better on the way. You're such a loving Father who wants the best for us. And thank you for all the time that has been invested to the kingdom today. Lord, bless them in everything, that they will have all abundance in all things. Thank you. I pray and remove right now the spirit of poverty from this house in every way, that our people, that we will always have abundance and plenty, that with joy we will be able to give. Joy with happiness. With happiness we'll be able to give. With such joy. Because we received from you. Help us, Lord. Give us more light on living with you joyfully. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.